Hi guys, I'm excited to be here with you today.
Thank you.
Please tell me your names and the name of this sweet little business that we're in.
Christine Toledo in Inspirations Catering and Gourmet Shop.
Manny Toledo, and I'm the husband.
Yes, I'm the husband. And so you guys have been at this a long time, 25 years?
Mm-hmm. Yep, 25 years. We started because Kelly at Legal Draft, we did some catering for them 4 years ago.
Okay.
And as soon as I walked out the door, I knew this is where we needed to be.
Yeah, she came to me and she said, we opened a place there. I don't know what, a restaurant, whatever, but we're going to open a place at the...
We're going to do something to be a part of this neighborhood.
Yeah, yes.
So were you operating out of your house before, or did you have another location?
We cook everything on site at locations, and then we also rented a kitchen in downtown Fort Worth. And so what allowed us to do prepping and certain things there, but then we like the freshness of cooking at someone's home or on site of an event. But we wanted to do something where we can meet customers here and do a little spin on it, which is where the charcuterie comes in.
Yes, so tell me a little bit about the business concept, what you do here in this space. I get that you do a lot of catering, mm-hmm. so a lot of your business goes out the door. Mm-hmm. But what do you do here?
So we do pairing classes with charcuterie and wine, and of course, Legal Draft beer. And then we do charcuterie classes, teaching people how to pull it together. We do lunches.
And we do our private dinners as well, where, you know, people come in and enjoy themselves, and it's a great group of people here to enjoy.
Family style, which is a different spin on the dinner because everything is served family style on our big charcuterie boards.
It's beautiful, the food presentation and the work that you do. That's why people keep coming back. So what different roles do you play? My sense is that you're the one dealing with the customers, you're the one out front.
I do the menus. I do all the sauces, the jams, of course the charcuterie. He has the patience for all the meats. I want that meat to just be done and come out. But he has the patience for cooking all that.
And so what are some of the things that require that kind of patience? You do some special things on a daily basis with your meats, right?
Well, there's a couple of different things you do, especially if you want to work on a lamb shop or lamb junk. You have to be able to know the temperatures and the times on that and just kind of get the rub in them and get the flavor going. Because it's about flavor, you know, anything else.
Everything we make is fresh. We don't believe in just cookie cutter. So everything we do is... If we have it that day, it's been made that day. No.
We believe that every opportunity we get to serve a client something different, something new, that has to be full of flavor.
And your charcuterie boards, you have so many different boards. Mm-hmm. Do you source locally for some of your products and some of your food?
Yes, we have two different companies that we get some of our cheeses from. They're about 3 hours from here, but we consider that local. Mm-hmm. And it's important to us just helping one another and just knowing where it came from.
And so being in business together and being married, 25 years, that's a long time. And so you guys are starting to do other things too. So how do you keep a balance between your work and your home life?
I would say sometimes we don't, honestly, because you could be wanting to go on a little trip and you find yourself talking about, oh, this may be good, or, you know, so it is a challenge, but then we have to take those little breaks and just say, we're not answering the phone today, we're not gonna answer emails today, which lasts till about 6 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
Because you do have a business to run. So, but yeah, you have to be patient with one another.
Mm-hmm. But one of the key things I always think is the respect. Respect in a relationship for your mate or, yes, in general.
So you guys first got exposed to this development that's part of downtown Urban Union by doing business with Legal Draft, but I see you all the time working with your neighbors. Can you talk about some of the collaborations you do with the other businesses around here?
We've had several, and we enjoy all of them. Mm-hmm. We do classes with Catalyst Creative Arts, mm-hmm. and they make such beautiful boards with the epoxy, and we've done different things with them where we do charcuterie in their classes. We do brunches at Legal Draft, So just anybody, you know, sugar bees, I will always recommend people for desserts over there. It's just nice to know that there are other businesses around here that have the same goals in mind.
Yes.
But we did go out to Levitt this last weekend with our new adventure, the Flying Pig, which is our food trailer.
So I have seen this in the parking lot the last 2 days, and I can't wait to hear about this.
Yes.
But I think to talk about the Flying Pig, we have to bring another person into the room because this is a family affair, right?
Yes.
That is correct.
Yeah, we are using our daughter, Sydney, and her skills that she'd learned, and she has kind of a different feel for some foods for the Flying Pig. So she is definitely going to implement some of those.
Well, let's invite her in to join us.
Okay.
Please introduce our new guest.
So this is Sydney, our youngest daughter. And she has actually been with us. She helped in the beginning here at the shop. Then she ventured out and has cooked at a few places. But with our new adventure, we brought her back.
So one of the things that I keep seeing here in the space are flying pigs.
Yes.
And I came to work yesterday and I saw this new trailer in the parking lot and there it was, Flying Pig.
Yes.
Please, tell me about the Flying Pig.
So that is a trailer that we just started with our business, and my dad and I are mainly going to be running around on that and cooking on it and everything. But when we were trying to think of what exactly we wanted to fit the same kind of food somewhat, but like take a spin on it and so make it a little different. So it's like gourmet, different kind of brunch, small bite kind of foods, like deep fried Nutter Butters, candy bacon, pancakes.
What? Yeah. Deep fried Nutter Butter, like cookies?
Deep fried Nutter Butters, yes. So from that, people like to think fair food, but it's way better than that. It's a step up for sure of that. So Nutter Butters, then we have the candied bacon pancakes, we have fried zucchini on a stick, and then we're still following with our bourbon meatballs. We have the candied bacon on the trailer,
grilled brisket, grilled cheese.
Yes. We'll have like our Cuban sandwich, so my dad will be like smoking all the porks and everything for that. But the name Flying Pig came from my mom always saying, oh, you can get that whenever pigs fly. We can do that when pigs fly. And I was like, oh, well, here we go. So
that's cute. And it kind of goes with Inspirations, which is the catering name.
Yes.
So it's going to be a father-daughter thing on the road.
Yes.
Yes.
That's great. So the next generation stepping in. So are you pretty much going to run the food trailer side of the business and learn the business
alongside
side of it?
Alongside with them, yes. They're teaching me how to operate a business, how to be the boss. Uh-huh. My dad started as a busboy over 40 years ago in this business and worked his way up. And so he says, you're a busboy. Sometimes I don't like hearing that. But it's the truth where you need to work up and learn. And so they're teaching me the reins of everything. And yeah, it's great, and I'm really excited for it, especially being in this area, already having some people that we're working with and community around us helping. It's been great. We've already been able to go to the Levitt for some of the summer concerts, and so we'll be able to come there. But yeah, excited for it.
Now, you've gotten culinary training as well along the way.
Yes, a little bit here and there, yeah.
So you bring that. That's really cool.
Yes. I was in school for it in high school and then took it into culinary school there for a little bit, but then I did more learning and studying, just working in the industry, and went to a couple jobs over in Dallas.
I can't wait to see what you're going to do with this trailer. Sounds like entrepreneurism really runs in the family.
It does. A couple generations back.
So. Yeah. And I didn't ask, what were you guys doing? If you were a busboy 40 years ago, you didn't have a career before that, because you're a young guy still, right?
That's right.
What were you guys doing before you started this restaurant business?
Well, I actually went to UTA, graduated there. While I was there, I had started designing at the World Trade Center the last 2 years of college. So I have a lot of design background, and that carried through.
And Manny, what were you doing before you guys started a business?
I was working for a hotel company for over 38 years.
Okay.
I started my career as a busboy.
Oh, wow.
You know, when you work as a busboy, then you have opportunities to move up with everything else. Being at that time, just new to the country, new to what business are,
Yeah, so you brought a lot of business experience and operations experience.
Yes.
Customer service.
Yes.
Absolutely. Thank
back you. Of the house and front of the house.
Yes.
That was one of the key things that I learned throughout my career. You know, you meet different clients every day.
Mm-hmm.
It's just on the hotel business as it is here in our business.
Yeah.
Every client that calls here is different. Mm-hmm. And they don't really care how long you've been in the business. They want to know if you're going to be able to take care of them and make them feel like they're important. You know, as we always tell our wedding people, that we want to custom the menu to you. It is easy for us to throw a menu, put it up there, but to have a menu for you personally, for your family, that's what we want to do.
Yeah,
so. That's amazing.
And customers are everything. They can go buy cheeses at any store. They can go buy, you know, different dishes at any store, but you need to make them feel special and that you are first on their mind, because without those customers, you will not exist. So we try to make that very, very important.
And your customer experience and your dining experiences are so high touch and so unusual that makes them very memorable.
Yeah, yeah, I hope so.
What do you guys think are the keys to entrepreneurship?
Don't think that what you have planned is going to happen the way you want it to happen, because everything will evolve and there will be surprises along the way. So you have to learn to go with the flow.
Really good point.
Yes.
I can't speak too much from that much experience because I'm just getting started, but I feel one thing that is easier if you're coming in and starting fresh to dream big and have those great ideas. And I don't like being told no for those ideas, because why not? And so just keep dreaming big for that, because when you're young, you have the innocence of not getting turned down or not having it not work. So you have those big dreams and goals. And so taking that with your business and sticking with it.
So clearly you guys think the future's bright down here. What do you think is going to happen in downtown Arlington over the next 5 years?
Well, hopefully a lot more foot traffic, because people still walk in and say, I can't believe what this looks like. I haven't been here in 10 years or whatever, and they're amazed at what is happening. So I think that's only going to grow.
Mm-hmm.
And they get really excited when we lead them to somewhere else, or we say, oh, don't worry, we work with that person on something. They get so excited that people down here work together. So I hope that only grows.
And what do you think, this younger generation?
I think this will be a community of a lot of family businesses or young entrepreneurs starting their own business. And I think Arlington sees that and they grab onto it. Mm-hmm. So instead of taking other corporate businesses that are around, they really do grab onto local people. So I think this will be a community of that kind of growth.
Yeah, downtown is very much where the locals go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we have this new energy around entrepreneurship and trying to create an ecosystem that will support and attract and retain even more businesses. And right here next to UTA, and with the support of the city and the vision of small businesses like you guys,
yeah,
it's only going to get better.
Yeah, I think so.
So Manny, what do you think is the future of downtown Arlington?
You know, just looking at the resilience of the people of last year during the pandemic that we really don't need to talk about that, because I think it's behind us in general. That is the reality. But seeing how the community of Arlington pulled together, not only here at the Urban Union operation, but yes, in general throughout the city, how everyone come together. The future of this area, I can wait to see it build up with new restaurants, new coffee shops, and you know, just new people, new entrepreneurs. They want to start new businesses. The future here and through Arlington, I think, is one of the best things.
Is there anything else that you want to promote or share with folks that's coming up with your company besides the watching for the flying pig out there?
What I have seen kind of coming back just in the past little bit are classes, our pairing classes, our charcuterie, because people are being able to get together now where they weren't for so long.
Yes.
And then our family dinners, because it's such a gathering. You know, when we started a couple years ago, our whole thing was, you know, everything was gathering around the table. And it still is, and I think it's even more important with people now after everything they've experienced. So that's one of our favorite things to do, is to set everything personalized for that group.
Well, you set a great table. I'm looking forward to eating some of the food.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us today here at Inspirations Catering and the Flying Pig with the Toledo family. We air on Facebook Live every other Wednesday at 2 o'clock, so we'll see you next time.